We're talking about Behringer's new X32 digital mixing console. This mixing console has been in development for over a year. Behringer bought Midas. So what you've got is the brain power of Midas along with the efficiency of production of Behringer. This mixer is designed to make it easy for somebody that has an analog console to get into the digital world. Let me show you what I mean. First of all, the X32 means we've got 32 input channels. There's 16 on two layers. So number one has, layer one has 1 through 16. I go to layer 2, and I've got 17 through 32. Fairly typical for digital mixers. If I go to the third layer, then I have my aux in and USB returns. I've got 8 aux ins, and they're line level inputs. So really, although it says X32, I've got a 40 channel mixer plus USB ins. So you've got 32 mic line inputs and another 8 line ins for auxes plus the USB. So what makes this an easy mixer to use for somebody that's familiar with an analog mixer? Well, let's move up to this section right now. First of all, go back to channel 1, select that, and you can see that instead of going to a touch panel, the channel strip is right up here and it's in an analog type of a format. So first of all, you've got your gain control, and that controls how much level is coming into the channel, just like a trim or a gain on any other mixer. You also have a low cut, so you can cut off the rumble from a microphone, a vocal microphone, and you can select what frequency that's at. You simply press low cut here and adjust that, and away you go. And you'll also see it over here on the digital display panel as well, but it's easy to see right here. The gate and the dynamics of the gate are right here. You can select whether you want a gate or a ducker, compressor or expander. Very easy to get to. And then the equalizer, you've got a 4-band EQ. So you've got high, high mid, low mid, and low. And you simply select which band you want to work with. Your Q is here, the frequency at which the EQ is going to impact or affect it is there, and then the gain of that. So it's a fully parametric 4-band EQ. Then you've got bus sends up here as well. 1 through 4, 5 through 8, 9 through 12, 13 through 16. So what's incredible on essentially a 40-channel mixer is that you've got 16 buses. Well, we use the buses not only for sends for aux sends to the monitors, but also our sends to the effects, and you can use them for recording as well. So 16 buses. You simply have 1 through 4. Now this is 1 through 4. If you select 5 through 8, then this is channels 5 through 8, and away you go. Again, very easy to always remember your channel strip is up here. The way I access that channel strip is by simply selecting the channel that I want to impact, I want to adjust. So if I select that one, I'm up on channel 6, I adjust the levels here. And by the way, as you can see, moving faders. And I also have a small LCD type readout. For instance, it says snare drum, hi-hat, and mid-tom. These are assignable through either a PC or on the LCD screen. And it makes it really easy to understand what is hooked up to channel 7. And you also have a small icon. Then we move over here to the master side, the typical left-right master, and you have bus controls here. So these are your masters for the buses, which are going to be your auxes, so bus 1 through 8, bus 9 through 16. So all 16 bus controls are here. You also have EQ and full dynamics on all of these outputs as well. Then we go, you have 6 mute groups, so you can select channels that are going to be on the mute group. Simply select which mute groups you're on. That's like an analog console as well. Very easy to understand. You might mute the vocals. You might mute the band with a mute group. You can also mute other input sources by simply pressing a button. Very easy to understand. You also have an assign area, so I can assign presets like a lighting console by simply selecting 1 through 8 on the presets. The wonderful thing about this console is that it uses an AES digital busing system, so it can plug directly into their 16-channel on-stage monitor system as well, and you can have remote inputs. So let me take a look. I'll pull this. This is an input box, a stage input box. So you have 16 channels coming in on the stage input box. You have 8 outputs. Those have phantom power on them. And by connecting it simply to Ethernet, one Ethernet cable right here, and you can daisy chain them, you can take the input box, a stage box, and connect it to the console with one Ethernet cable. You also have output for their personal monitor system. And the personal monitor system is pretty incredible in that it has 16 channels it can access off of this console. So let me grab that, show you that. So the P16M, you select any of these 16 channels, you've got a little bit of tone control, you've got level control for those, but again, you're running it on the Ethernet cable, and you're assigning which of the 40 channels on this console go to this particular 16-channel personal monitor mixer through the selection page on the LCD readout over here. So I can assign any of these channels to that personal monitor, and then the person on stage simply uses that like an Avium system or like a Roland system and any of the other systems that you're familiar with. Check these out. Give us a call at CCI Solutions for the X32 Behringer Digital Mixing System.